Hi there, it's Laurel here, and today I am going to do a little Copic coloring over glitter, and I'm doing this as part of the lawnscaping challenge that runs for the next 10 days, which is to try a new technique, and I have never colored over glitter before. So I've got this Let's Roll stamp and die by Lawn Fawn, and I've grabbed my Misty here, which is the best, well, I guess I should say it's the most incredible stamping tool invented. It's a super cool stamping tool if you're not familiar with it. It works as a acrylic block and a stamp positioner all in one. It's super cool. So anyway, I've got those images kind of lined up on just some cardstock here, and I'm just going to stamp them all at one time. I'm using some VersaFine Onyx black ink, but really any ink will work for this. I just wanted a dark, crisp black outline for my images here. So because it's a pigment ink, I need to make sure I set it aside and give it some time to dry. So while I am doing that, I've got some of this sticky double-sided tape sheets by Best Creation. So the front and the back of those sheets are both sticky, but both the front and the back also have lining papers. I'm sure there are a million ways to do this. This is the way that I found was the easiest after trying a couple of other ways, which wound up in the garbage can. So anyway, I've got the coordinating dies, just when I'm counting, making sure I've got my four dies on there. I've got my four images stamped. And then I ran them through my Vagabond. And as you can see, they die cut the images for me. So what I'm going to do here is peel off the back side, the brown lining paper, and then stick it directly over my stamped image there. So that front paper, lining paper, is still there. So the stickiness on the front is not revealed yet. So what I'm doing is I need to create a sticky surface here so my glitter will stick to it. So I'm using the brown piece to make sure I'm putting the dye there on the sushi the right way. The sushi set is awesome. And if you don't know me, I love me some sushi. I sure do. For the longest time, I wouldn't even try the raw stuff. And then when I finally did, I was like, why was I wasting all my money on the cooked stuff? This raw stuff is awesome. And it's good for you. That's what I'm telling myself. The tuna is really good for you. And the tuna is really good. Anyway, all right, so I've got all of my pieces on there. So now it's time to, oh, I didn't show that on camera. I'm so sorry, but I peeled off the front lining papers of those dies. And now it's all sticky on my card. I'm sorry, I don't know why I didn't film that. But anyway, I just peeled off the lining paper off of the front. And so it's all sticky and gooey and yummy. So I've got some Micro Fine Glitter by Glitter Ritz. It's the cool highlights. It's a really fine glitter, super fine. And I like this the best when I know I'm going to do something over the top, because I'm going to burnish it with my finger here. And burnishing, what it's doing is it's kind of rubbing it all in, making sure it's all good. And that way it's not going to fall all over the place when you mail it. It's almost like a velvet when you're done, when you burnish it in. And no little specks of glitter comes off on your fingers anymore after you get it burnished. It's hard to see the glitter right here, but when we add the color, you'll see it. So that's why I burnish it. See, it's all nice and sparkly. This is what it turns into when you add the color. So I'm going to be using Copic markers for this, but you can use any kind of marker. So I'm going in with I was going to try to do a little bit of shading, but it's pretty hard to do over this glitter. So you can see I'm using the tip of my marker. It did not damage my tip at all, and there were no leftover little glitter flakes on my marker. But if it's something that concerns you about ruining your markers, just use the side of your marker. You'll also see me start scribbling off onto scratch paper because I'm crazy. There was, again, no signs of glitter on the tips of my marker, but I just went ahead and scribbled off to the side anyway, just in case there was something on there that I wasn't seeing. So that's why you'll see me continue to do that. So again, I'm going in with just basic Copic coloring here. I'm trying to put the caps down so you can see the colors that I'm using in case you're interested. This is my favorite like color family, this teal and the soft pool colors. I love that. My daughter's room is this pretty, it's called China Blue from Benjamin Moore. It's such a pretty color. It's very soothing. And I just love that color. But anyway, I don't know why I'm talking to you about that. So I've got all the color down. So I decided to go ahead and adhere the little food tray here down flat to my card base here. This is just some Nina Solar White 80-pound cardstock. It's trimmed down to 4 by 5 1/4. So I'll have that 1/4 inch mat around the base when we're done here. So I've decided I'm going to pop up the little sushi and the little soy sauce there. So I've got some Scotch double-sided tape. I love this tape for two reasons. Well, I guess three. You can get it in this ginormous roll that's like the circumference of my face. So you'll have it for a very long time. And also you don't need scissors to cut it. You can just tear it with your fingers, as you can see. And then that backing paper, you just peel off and discard. Now, it's hilarious. I throw these little backing papers off to the side when I'm done. Sometimes I throw them on the ground. Sometimes I throw them over my head. I find these little backing papers all over my craft room because when I'm peeling them off, I really don't think about, you know, maybe putting them in the garbage can. I don't know. Anyway, so I've got my little soy sauce all poked, raised up there a little bit, and then I've got my cute little sushi, my little happy sushi that I'm about to eat. Yum, yum, yum. So there's my heart. Now, this is funny. I put on some glue there, and I was like, why is that so white? Because I used Ranger, it's white acrylic paint. My bad. I needed to use the multi-matte medium glue. Those bottles look very similar, so I just kind of wiped off that white paint and put on the multi-matte medium glue, which is what I had intended to use to begin with, not the white acrylic paint. Okay, so this is Claire's ABCs by Lawn Fawn. I wanted to come up with a little sentiment there. And at first I thought I was going to do nom, 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 you know, like nom, nom, nom. But I thought that maybe some of you wouldn't know what that meant. I don't know. So I decided to change it up to yum, yum. So I'm going to take out the N and O and I'm going to switch it out with a Y and U. And you can see how easy it is to just nestle those stamps right into each other and you get the perfect sentiment every time. So I wanted to show you how easy it was to kind of mount it on your block there. I've got a block with grid lines. I can't encourage the grid line blocks enough. And then I'm just going to go ahead and stamp out yum yum. Because I love, if you know me at all, I love sushi. So I could have just left it alone here, but I didn't. I wanted to add some little flicks here. So I've got some white mist here, and I'm just going to flick some on with a stick. You can see I grabbed a rag to cover up my little images there. So I flick some on just to give it a little bit of interest in that background. I could have just left it alone. And look at that sparkle and shine from the color and that glitter. That microfine glitter, I tell you, the microfine glitter is key when coloring over it. And that way it doesn't all come out all over the place, come out all over your hands and whatnot. So I've got a black card base there. It's just a standard A2 fold, 4.25 by 5.5. Matte, and you'll see I made a big boo-boo. I didn't let the mist dry, so you see that little black mist up there in the top left-hand corner? It looks like it's now got a little tail on it. So I'm going to go in and try to fix it. I can't get rid of the little tail, but that's okay. You know, little fish have tails, and you get some fish eggs on your sushi, so it all goes together. You know what I'm saying? So I decided to add a little bit more mist to the bottom just to kind of equal everything out on the card, and then that's it for the day. For this card, when I go over that glitter with my hand, none of it comes off. So that's what I like about this kind of glitter. I don't like glitter that comes off all over the place, which is why usually I don't use glitter too much at all. So that's the card. I colored over glitter. It's a new technique for me. Head on over to my blog if you're interested in any of the supplies, or if you want a link to the challenge that's going on right now at Lawnscaping, that's over at my blog too. Thank you so much for watching. Have an awesome day.